Hello everyone, yesterday there has been an announcement of an observation that indicates evidence of new physics beyond the Stan model, this time from the Fermilab muon g-2 experiment. This has been found from the g-2 experiment that muons, the heavy currents of electrons, have a g-factor that does not match the theoretical predictions from the Stan model of particle physics. Theorists predict the g-factor of the muon to be 2.00233183620. And the g-2 experiment has observed the g-factor of the muon to be 2.00233184080. This may not sound that different, but this is different enough to have been come not from experimental errors, but from new particles or forces that are beyond the Stan model. Now let's delve a little deeper to understand what actually has happened. Particles like electrons and muons have what we call a spin, which is an inherent property of fundamental particles. And this makes them behave as if they are tiny little magnets with magnetic fields. All magnets, charged moving in a loop, and fundamental particles with spin have a magnetic field and a magnetic moment, which determines the strength of the magnetic field. When the magnetic properties of these particles was first observed, this has been thought by the scientists that the magnetic moment of these particles would follow the same formula as any other magnet do. But this has been observed that the electron has a magnetic moment which is actually twice of what was predicted using the classical formula. The 2 here is termed as the g-factor. This happens because the spin of the electron is half, and an astonishing feature of spin half particles is that they need to rotate twice to come to their original quantum state and not once. For years after that, it was thought that the g-factor of the electron and muon is exactly 2. But later it was observed that the g-factor of electron is not actually 2, it is 2.00 11614. This was explained by the different ways by which virtual particles can interact with the electron and affect its magnetic moment. Virtual particles are created by the space itself. They come in pair and quickly get annihilated. Virtual particles are also the force carrier in the quantum field theory. That means muons also does not have a g factor of exactly 2. In the g-2 experiment, g refers to a g factor, 2 refers to a g factor without taking into account the interactions with virtual particles, and g-2 gives us the g factor that has been contributed by the interactions of virtual particles with the real particles. The g factor of the electron measured theoretically using the Stan model matches perfectly with the g factor of the electron measured experimentally. But this is not the case with the muon. In 2001, the results announced by the Brookhaven National Laboratory reported differences between observed and predicted values of the g-factor of the muon. The thing is that by taking into account all of the known virtual particle interactions in the Stan model, there is always some difference that exists between the theory and the measurement of the value of the g-factor of the muon. That means there is some unknown particle or forces in our universe that is outside of the Stan model that is interacting with the muon and affecting the g-factor of the muon. This happened with muon and not with electron because muon is about 200 times massive than the electron. And the probability of an interaction with a virtual particle is proportional to the mass of the particle square. That means a muon is about 200 square or 40,000 times more likely to interact with a virtual particle than an electron. Now the results announced by the Fermilab muon g-2 experiment has shrunken the uncertainty. The uncertainty in measurement is now about 4.2 sigma. 4.2 sigma is not enough to claim this observation a discovery. We need over 5 sigma to claim it as a discovery. The g-2 experiment is not over. It will take more data in the future. Thus, the uncertain measurement will get better over time. Recently, data from LHCb experiment also observed anomaly in the Stan model and the observation. All these things are point towards new physics that is yet to be discovered. We really don't know what physics we will encounter in the future.